Hello everybody, and thank you for watching this new video. Today we are going to talk about lip sync using Papagayo and Clip Studio Paint. Did you know Papagayo is this simple software? Papagayo only do one thing, but do it really well, and it synchronizes the mouth shapes with the audio. Several software are compatible with Papagayo, but for now, Clip Studio is not one of them. To use it, all you have to do is open an audio. In this case, I'm using this audio from the show One Piece. This is for a reanimate project in which I want to contribute. Let's listen to the audio.
Go find a boat and give it to Kobe. He's leaving your ship to join the Marines. Not gonna stop it.
So with the audio in the software, the thing you need to do is to write the sentence the character is saying. Then you need to break the phonemes. Just press this button. Always remember to check the frame rate of the Papagayo file, because this will synchronize with your animation. In my case, I'm going to use 24 FPS. To edit this file, what you do is to extend or place this green bar between the start and the end of the speech. You don't need to put it from the beginning to the end of the audio, because this audio start with some music and finish with music, so it's when the character is starting the speech and when it finish. Then you can scrub, just click and drag, and you can scrub around the audio, and in this way you can place all the words in the correct spot for each word in the audio. You need to be aware of where everything is to keep it in the right position. And when you finish, everything will be perfect. I'm not going to do it live. What I'm going to use is a file I already finished. You can even change the shape of the mouth. For example, this is a Preston Blair mouth shape. So you can see how powerful Papagayo is. You can even modify the phonemes individually until you are satisfied with the result. This is a superficial explanation of the software. There are a lot of good tutorials on YouTube, so you can check one of these tutorials. I recommend the one made by Darren T. It's quite good. So I'm going to place a link in the description if you want to check Darren T tutorial. Now I can export the file and name it Command or whatever. Luffy Command and save. Now I'll find the file in the Windows Explorer. Is the .dat file. So right click and select open with notepad. And this is what you get. The first part is a number and it represents the frame. And the second part is the name of the mouth. The names of these mouths must be the same used for the software Papagayo. Here you can see that I create a layer for each mouth. You can see the names are exactly the same in Papagayo and in Clip Studio. So to translate the Papagayo file to something that Clips can understand, I create a template in Google Sheets. I tried several options, but for me this is the one that is simpler. So to use it, you just need to copy the data from the notepad. And in the sheet template, just paste it. But it's necessary to separate the frames and the layer in two different columns. So to do this, just click here and select split text to columns. Then use the space as a separator. And it creates this. can see, are separated in different columns. If you didn't get the pop-up like the one I get, you just need to go to Data and select Split Text to Columns. Then you select the separator. You can see that the first value is placed already in this column, and the second is placed too, but in reverse from the originals. There is no enough space for all the data, so to fix that, just cut the footer info, select everything, cut, then paste it after the last value. Now I extend the columns until the end of all the data. The same with column C and column E. Column B is equal to column H, so I will extend it until the end. And I will do the same with column D. Finally, it's necessary to decide the duration of the timeline in frames. So, because my last mouth is placed in frame 145, I will make the timeline to last maybe 180 frames. This number will fill these two spots here. If you analyze the file, you can see that there are things that you can edit, but for simplicity, let's use it as it is. Copy this and in the notepad file, select all and paste it. You need to copy this space. This is just a tab space, you know, when you press tab, the tab key. But we need to erase all the tabs. These are from the Google Sheets file. Replace it with nothing. So press replace all. And finally, you need to save this file. It's necessary to change the extension to xtds. Save the file in a folder that you can remember. Now, this is the file I create, so open Clip Studio. If you want to follow this example, I'm going to share this file. In the file, you can find this character, Luffy from One Piece. But if you don't like to use these kind of characters, you can. I let a generic shape, a generic character that you can use. I'm using Luffy, so because of the reanimate project. So in the Windows Explorer, drag the xtds file over the Clip Studio software like this and drop it in whatever place, it's not important. I don't need this anymore. So go to the animation folder in the timeline. Right click in the first frame and select the rest mount. Then you can import the audio file in File, Import Audio. This is my audio. Let's test how it works.
Go find a boat and give it to Kobe. He's leaving your ship to join the Marines. Not gonna stop it.
You can see that the end of the frame is wrong. So you can place a rest mount here and play again.
Go find a boat and give it to Kobe. He's leaving your ship to join the Marines. Not gonna stop it.
You can change the mount if you feel like. For example, here. Or you can choose any mouth you want in this animation folder. after you finish and you are satisfied, you can left click and drag over the timeline to copy all the cells of this sequence. Then you can hide this folder or this character. And I'm going to use a different character, a character with a different expression in the mouth. In this case, you can change the name of the folder, it's not important. You can change it for example, mouth. If you want, you can delete everything and then right click and paste. You can see the difference in the mouth shape. Let's check the animation.
Go find a boat and give it to Kobe. He's leaving your ship to join the Marines. Not gonna stop it.
And that's it. How you can use Papagayo with Clip Studio Paint. It's not, but it's quite simple, and you can save a lot of time because, you know, there is no scrub in Clip Studio, so making the lip sync is time consuming. You can use this file, for example, as a reference for different characters. What the file gave you is the position of the mouth that you are going to use. So it can be a reference, or it can be the way you animate all the dialogues. You can save a lot of time because it's a reference for you and it's a perfect way to create a lip sync fast and precise. Well, thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.
Go find a boat and give it to Kobe. He's leaving your ship to join the Marines. Not gonna stop it. Go find a boat and give it to Kobe. He's leaving your ship to join the Marines. Not gonna stop it.